When you're gone and I'm all by myself, and I need your caress, I just think of you, and the thought of you holding me near makes my loneliness soon disappear. Meditating how sweet life will be when you come back to me.
Keep trying. Don't give up.
Good move. Whoa. Whee.
You're doing it.
Woo. I'm going to apply for a nursery for Rufus, which is a really weird feeling. Again, I knew I would feel like this because when I put Grayson in nursery, I felt exactly the same. And I don't want to really put him in, but I feel like just a couple of afternoons a week will benefit both of us in terms of like, I can actually concentrate on work and like having dedicated time to be able to do work to the best of my ability. And also him just being able to socialise with other babies. I just think that that's so good. And I remember when Grayson was at nursery before, that was one of the things that made me like an advocate for nursery days, because he picked up so much from the other babies and he really enjoyed it. And I think Rufus will too, because he's really sociable. Like whenever we go to like little groups or soft plays or anything, he loves playing with the other children. So I think he'll really like it. It's just more my guilt and like, oh, my baby, and like giving him away to somebody, which is weird, but I don't think they've got any space at the moment anyway, so I'll probably have a little bit longer to get used to the idea. And it won't be for long, and like anyway, but yeah. Anyway, now that I've rabbited on about that, I'm gonna get the pushchair ready and stuff.
Come on then, you little monkey.
Baba.
Okay. You've got Grayson's whole outfit on when he was little. Okay, you want those? And take those. Ready? Ready? You got hold of the pot? Yeah? We're just walking the back way into town. I call it the country way because it is pretty much right next to the countryside and I love it. This is the walk that I used to do with Rufus when he was a newborn. He would only sleep either on me or if I took him out in the pram, and it was freezing cold because it was like October, I think, last year was when it was like snowing and stuff. But I just always remember walking this exact walk to get him to go to sleep, and I remember exactly where on this street that he would fall asleep, and he's just nodded off now. Setting up the Christmas market stalls. I'm so excited about that.
Right, mate. How you been?
Yeah, good.
This is my hairdresser. His name is Alex, but I just call him mate. The truth is, I don't even need a haircut. I just enjoy getting to spend some time with someone who's passionately interested in my plans for the weekend. Alex is a man who doesn't shy away from a bit of high-level banter. No holes barred, a good chop and a chat. It's become a sort of running joke that every time I come in for my weekly chop, he's just about to pop out for an early lunch or just runs out the back. So I just normally sit down and wait for him. But I guess that's what friends do. They joke around with each other, tease, play games with your self-esteem. But let's face it, it's a great deal for him. He's literally being paid money to be absolutely fascinated by an almost 40-year-old vlogger. I even hinted once that perhaps he should be the one paying me, but he just laughed it off. Or at least for free, I said after he stopped laughing, but he just looked a bit confused. You see, the beauty of our relationship is he never bothers to waste my time by talking about himself. He did try once, but it became a bit awkward. I was telling him about my new social influencer Holland & Barrett Black Card that gives me 20% off pretty much everything in-store and online, when he suddenly started to cry. He was blubbering something about a beloved family pet cat being put down later that day or something. I wasn't really sure what to say, so I just read him some of my latest tweets to take his mind off it. It seemed to make it worse.
Fantastic.
Alright.
Always get really scared when you do that in case I see that ball patch, but no, not there yet.
Yeah. Not yet. It's on its way.
Cheers, bud.
Cheers.
Thanks, man.
Did you have a good day at school?
Yeah. Come on then, hurry up.
Gracie. Have you noticed Daddy's haircut? Daddy got a haircut with Alex.
Yeah, I got a haircut. You didn't even say anything about it. Shows how much attention you pay to your dad's hair.
Hey, Mum, you haven't got a haircut.
You say have. Why do you think I look extra handsome? Hi.
I'm a student at Bath, and I wondered if I'd ever bump into you.
What's your name?
Bella.
Nice to meet you, Bella.
Lovely to meet you. Thank you so much.
I would shake your hand, but I'm really sticky.
No problem.
Why are you sticky?
Because I just, I just picked up Grayson's hot chocolate spillage.
Hey, who's that?
Thank you so much. I'm really happy.
Really nice to meet you.
Thank you so much.
Hope to see you again.
Yeah, hope to see you again.
Good luck with your exams. Take care,
babe. Bye.
Why did I say that?
Don't know.
She's probably not even having an exam.
I am going to order the boys a massive toy trunk because I feel a little bit like we're drowning in toys in this room and I just want it to be more of an adult space when they've gone to bed, so I'm going to order them via a company called Klarna, who we are very happy to be working with this week.
Klarna are a Swedish startup founded in 2005 that have massively expanded over the past few years. They now have 60 million customers across 90,000 merchants in 14 countries. In simple terms, they help you pay for the things you buy online from thousands of retailers. You can pay in installments through their Slice It product in a safe and secure manner. Let me give you an example. Let's say, unlike Hannah and I, you have actual friends that like you and don't just feel a bit sorry for you. And those friends of yours are coming over for a swanky dinner party. You've got the David Gray playlist lined up, some cheese and pineapple impaled on cocktail sticks, the Blossom Hill Rosé chilling in the fridge, you're ticking all the boxes. But there's a big problem. Your table is too small. You need to buy a bigger table so none of your friends have to sit on the floor and be depressed. The only problem is you don't get paid for 3 more weeks. Well, back in the olden days when everything was far worse, you'd have to wait until you got paid. But not anymore. When you're checking out on the website of one of their retailers like Swoon here, you can pay with Klarna. This allows you to pay Klarna back in small chunks, rather than pay for everything all at once. So you can have all your friends around for your perfect dinner party and everyone will have one of the best nights of their lives.
So I'm going to order this toy chest and select Slice It at the checkout. It's super easy and great if you don't want to pay for it all in one go.
Weary of the blues, I'm weary of wanting
the love that you refuse, I'm weary of. I finally got Rufus to sleep. He did not want to go down for his morning nap this morning. He was tired, I just don't know why he wouldn't fall asleep. So in the end I just gave him a really, really, really long cuddle till he fell asleep. I am gonna get on the bike and go get an Instagram photo with Ollie. So I'm gonna leave editor husband here. I'm leaving you here. I'm gonna go get a photo.
Okay, cool, have fun. I love you.
Laugh me more.
See you when you get back.
I was gonna show you my outfit of the day because I'm shooting it today. So I've got a coat from Very, jumper is from Vera Moda at Amazon, got my Mags London necklace, got some Topshop jeans, and then my trainers are also from Amazon. I don't know what we're gonna do when we move into our new house next year because it's so much smaller than this house. I don't even know where I'm gonna keep the buggy because the hallway in the new house is just really like skinny, and if you had a buggy in there then you would basically not be able to walk through the hallway. I'm so excited about it though. I keep walking past the house like a weirdo. I bet they see me walking past, like, oh, there's that creepy girl again. I'm trying not to get too excited because obviously things can still fall through, and try not to get too excited, but I am really excited.
I'll be glad to share.
That's a camera. Yeah. Camera. 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 You saying camera? Think you saying camera? Woo! Camera. Oh, mister.
So this was the shoot location. We're just on the end of the Crescent. I've been eyeing up this house for ages and wanting to take a picture there. It did have like loads of kind of cool autumnal like red leaves growing on it at some point. But I just missed it. But I really like the location anyway. Sorry if, I don't know why I'm saying sorry. But yeah, I think we got the shot. I'm happy with it. Just as a little outfit post. I'm gonna cycle to Meticulous Ink on Walcott Street in Bath, which is the card shop that I have been working with, collaborating with, to learn calligraphy and make Christmas cards for my website, Mags London. And so this morning, Athena, the lady who owns the shop, has just emailed saying they're ready to be printed. So I'm gonna go in and watch the Christmas cards being printed. But yeah, I'm really excited to put them on the shop because we worked really hard designing them, and like learning calligraphy in itself was just like a process. So yeah, we're gonna go and watch them get printed.
Hannah has gone in to see the cards being printed in Meticulous Ink. I'm really proud of her for these, well, for everything she does on Mags London. If you work for yourself, you have to spread yourself over a few different things. So if one plate stops spinning and falls to the ground, then you're backed up. So she works really hard on Mags London to make sure that if ever this all comes crumbling down, then we have some sort of backup, I suppose. I'm doing a similar type of thing with WantFeed. So we're just trying to build things that, so we're not leveraged just on this one thing.
We're just checking the ink at the moment. I don't know the technical term. These pieces of paper behind me will all be cards soon.
The thing is, as a creator, you don't want to get lazy. I don't think you don't want to like find a rhythm and just stick to it. I feel as a creator, you have a responsibility and a duty to take people to places they necessarily don't always want to go to. Sometimes you want to take them where they want to go, but sometimes you can take them places that they don't want to go to. And I think you learn most about yourself when you're in unfamiliar and uncomfortable situations. So sometimes when I veer these videos off somewhere to some place, to places people don't really like, it kind of sorts the wheat from the chaff. I think a lot of the people who just like, give me what I want or I'm not interested in watching this, are not the sort of people that we want to make the videos for. The sort of people we want to make videos for are the people who are just like happy for us to kind of bounce around and try new things and experiment a bit. What do you want? What do you want? It's nice to know that your community give you the freedom to do that. It's nice to know that you have people behind you that are like, I love that, or you know, that I wasn't into that, but I'm happy for you to do it anyway. One thing I can't deal with is being like policed, like being told what to produce. It puts my back up. No, Rufus, you can't play with that. It's the phone. Dude, you've got so many toys. Why do you have to play with a little bit of ceramic and glass? Just
All right, play with it then, play with it. There, look, it's over there. Go and play with it then, go on, it's yours. You know what really does excite me about these videos? What really excites me about them is that I know one day that Rufus and Grayson will be watching them with their kids. I think as a parent, your job isn't just to kind of give your kids security and feed them and clothe them and educate them. It's also to help shape how they see the world. It's also to give them a prism in which to look through, and I think the way you interact with the world will heavily affect how they do it. And I feel that you have a responsibility as a parent for them to teach them how to fall in love with the world. There's a lot about this place which is brutal and cold and sinister and dark, but there's so much more of it which isn't that.
There we go. There it is.
So that's that then. So they'll be printing those for the rest of the day now. It's such a like a process. It's really interesting actually, what goes behind it, and the machine, you can't just leave it. Like you have to keep monitoring it and changing the ink levels and stuff, because it's such an old machine. It's like a 1960s printing press. It's beautiful. It's actually got a really nice cathartic sound as well when it's printing. So yeah.
Oh, somebody's at the door. This could be. Yes, it's UPS. That means it could be the camera. Let's have a look.
Yes, Rufus. Yes.
It lets me shoot not only in RAW, but it has a flip out screen.
Hey! Mummy's home. Oh wow, that looks amazing.
Doesn't it?
Oh, that's awesome, man. That's so exciting.
Oh no, someone's just said there's a spelling mistake on it.
No, there's not.
It says letter R press instead of letter press. Oh yeah, she's right.
Oh shit, it's just tell it to message Athena now. Shit. Yeah, message Athena, say Athena, I'm really sorry.
I wonder if I should call.
Yeah, call up quickly. How many she printed off, I wonder?
And not very many, they literally just started, maybe like 10 or 20.
I just called it because someone just messaged me on Instagram and said there's a spelling mistake on the back of the card.
A few of you very kindly messaged me on Instagram saying there's a spelling mistake on the back bit, which there is. So luckily we've been able to stop it from being printed while we rectify the situation. We did, believe it or not, we did pre-read this, but I think Steph and I tend to do everything in a rush because we've always got a million and one things to do, so it's totally our fault, but whoops. So that's gonna have to be redone.
The following scene is a typical morning in our household. It all starts at 6:30 a.m. when Rufus decides that sleeping is for losers. At 6:45 a.m. I go to CrossFit because yes, I'm that guy. At 7 a.m. Hannah puts some food inside our children. 7:30 a.m. Hannah dresses Grayson for school. At 7:45 a.m. Grayson watches a few cartoons while Rufus wrecks the house. 8 a.m. I get home from CrossFit and for the next 30 minutes tell Grayson to put on his shoes.
Come on, Grace face.
Make a wish.
Bye, Grayson, love you. Have a good day.
8:30 a.m. Grayson finally puts on his shoes and I ride him into school. And that is a typical morning in our house, as you were.
Rufus has a newfound love for ducks. Whenever he sees a picture of them, he's like, quack, 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 quack. So I have brought him to Victoria Park Duck Pond with some bread for the ducks, and we're gonna feed them. I'm hoping we don't get mauled, because I don't think I'll be able to hide my fear, and then it'll rub off on him. So yeah, let's do this.
Around this time of year, all the good games come out for the Xbox. I've got the new Assassin's Creed Origins and Red Dead Redemption 2, and Assassin's Creed Origin is way better than Red Dead Redemption 2 in my eyes. Red Dead Redemption 2 pissed me off because there was a mission where I had to be a debt collector.
You borrowed money from my business partner, Herr Strauss. You owe him, you took the money.
And I didn't want to pay like 60 quid to be a debt collector.
Where's our money?
I don't have it.
And I had to beat this poor guy up to get this little bit of money out of him. And it was like, my mum was sitting next to me and it was making me punch him. And I didn't want to hit him. He was like, I'm sorry, mate, I don't have the money.
Please, I have a family, sir, please. I'm doing my best for you.
You are a slippery little bastard.
And the only option I had was to give him another punch. And my mum was like, can you not just leave him alone? Can you not like let him off? And I was like, I would love to let him off, but I can't. There's no other option but to punch this guy in the face. And then his family came out, and his family were like, please leave our dad alone. He's not very well.
Thomas!
What are you looking at?
Thomas!
I said, what you looking at, woman?
My husband isn't well.
Get us the money.
So I was essentially paid money to be a debt collector, beating up an ill father who couldn't afford to pay his debts. And then I just stopped playing after that mission. When I've finally forgiven Red Dead Redemption for that horrible mission it put me on, then I will go back to it. And there's probably a way that I could have not taken that mission or whatever, I don't know. But it transpired that I was in that situation, I didn't want to be there, and I was angry, and I walked away angry at myself. And the protagonist, the guy who I'm playing, I hate him. I don't want him to win. I want him to die. I'm not interested in him succeeding. This stupid cowboy bloke, he's just annoying. Yeah, anyway, enough of that.
Quack, quack, yeah.
Yeah, outro time. We haven't done one of these in a while, have we?
I know, weirdly, I kind of missed them.
Yeah, I think it's time to bring them back.
At least for a while.
Yeah, I think with the whole bringing these videos back to what they were, I think outros were a big part of them, and I feel, I don't know, I just feel like it would be nice to have them back.
I do too, but I always feel like there's pressure that I never do my hair for them, and then I look back at them and I'm like, oh, I wish I did my hair that day. Let's see if Rufy will kiss me. Rufy, give Mummy a kiss.
Daddy, have a kiss.
Yay,
you're such a good boy. You're such a cute. I can't
Mummy
handle this cuteness.
Why did I get one?
Did he have a kiss?
Wow. Why did you get them? That's not fair.
Did you enjoy this week's video, Rufus?
Yeah, no,
I didn't have any boob. I didn't have any boob.
Are those poppers?
Yeah, they're poppers.
How very toddler-like of you.
I love poppers. When you get undressed, you just like rip it open. You feel really manly and like masculine. Can you say that these days? No, you can't have my glasses, you monkey.
Oh, I've got to take him for his injections today.
I know, you poor thing. Anyway, thanks to everyone who's been really supportive over Mags London and ordered a product from the site. It does genuinely mean a lot to us when you do that.
I always find it really weird as well. I'm like, oh, someone's actually liked something that I put on there. Right, I better skedaddle because this one is a boob fiend right now. Look, he's pulling my top down. Ah, okay. I'll have to go and give the nah.
Okay. Rufus needs to go and suck a boob, so we got to go. See you later, everyone. Thank you for watching. We'll see you all next week for more shenanigans. Bye. I did jazz hands.
I did a double wave earlier as well.